All right, time to get the skinny with Molly Kimball. If we are celebrating the Super Bowl or if we're boycotting the Super Bowl, there's a good chance that we're going to see some cheese on Sunday.
Right. Or just when we have people over. It's right. The easiest thing to kind of spread out, kind of have our array there. And I love it. And I love really good kind of fancy cheeses. But most of them, or I would say many of them, don't have the nutrition facts label on them.
Ooh.
So sometimes if you're really trying to keep things in check, you may just avoid it entirely and not realize that there are actually some that are better.
Right.
And so to put it out there, I'm not a big fan of low-fat cheeses. Okay. I think that most of them don't have a lot of flavor. So we're talking real good cheese mm-hmm. that you'd want to serve to your friends.
In small doses, right?
Right, in small doses.
Portion.
Good point.
Consider portions.
So when you look at the things that, why someone would say, oh, I shouldn't eat cheese.
Yeah.
Cheese is naturally typically high in sodium. It's also high in animal-based saturated fats. And it can also be high in calories. So those that we're talking about in our Lovitz are lower sodium.
Okay.
They still do have a decent bit of animal saturated fat, mm-hmm. and you have to keep portions in check. An ounce is about like our thumb.
Wow.
When you're slicing it off of, say, a block of cheese, that's about the width of your thumb. So it's
wow.
not a lot.
Okay.
And a lot of these cheeses have about 8 servings in what we're looking at here.
Okay.
So what I've got in the Lovitz, this is fresh mozzarella.
Mm-hmm.
Carla said, well, what about burrata?
Yeah.
That would fall in here too.
Okay.
And the reason they're in here because these are lower sodium, about 85 to 90 milligrams of sodium. A lot of typical cheeses can be in the 300s.
Wow.
And that's also why I have goat cheese here. So a lot of people reach for feta, you crumble it over a salad.
Mm-hmm.
If you make the switch from feta to goat cheese, mm-hmm. you'll save 75% of the sodium.
Wow.
It is the biggest change you can make as far as if you like those crumbled cheeses.
Okay,
and so if
perfect.
You like feta, you're probably going to like goat.
Love it.
With our Eat Fit restaurants, mm-hmm. that's the easiest switch we make, and it drives the sodium down a ton.
Incredible.
This for Swiss, I love the Jarlsberg Light.
Uh-huh.
So if you haven't tried it, I love that product. Again, for the same reasons, lower sodium, lower animal fats. What I have in the Like It,
mm-hmm.
these are just regular cheeses. And so this is your fancy cheeses, your brie, your cheddar. Most of them range from 70 to 120 calories per ounce,
okay.
and about 60 to 330 milligrams of sodium, so wide variation there. What I put in the Like It next to it,
yeah.
this is a goat's milk feta.
Wow.
So sort of like goat cheese, lower mm-hmm. sodium, the goat's milk feta also is about half the sodium of traditional feta. And then what I have in the Hate It, this is our traditional feta,
right.
high sodium, but even the fat-free feta in here has a lot of starches and a lot of carbs that you
wow.
might not expect in there. And then of course the things like Velveeta and
kind
then,
of some of the typical stuff that you just grab.
Just grab.
Convenience,
And
right.
if you're getting that Tostitos dip, you're also getting a bunch of artificial food dyes and
oh,
everything
no,
else.
Oh no, you don't want that. All right, no. so WGNO.com, we've got all this information. Molly, you're coming back with dip, so we can't
yes.
wait to hear about that. Hank? I know you're not a goat cheese fan. Sorry.
Nah, I can't do it. Always too gamey for me. A lot of people like it, though, I know. Out the door.